Hello, people. Yo, people. Hello, people. This is Jack. It is cold. It is cold. It's probably like midnight. I'm in the garage, in the car. I was just in the garage, but the heater went on. It was too loud, so I had to get in the car. It's freezing. And the amazing atheist is posting up. Well, his typical video. Well, it's not typical. Amazing atheist is... Well, sometimes he's... We're all typical. I mean, there's no point in me saying he's typical. I'm typical. Everyone's typical. Anyways. You know, I was surprised, TJ... Or actually, I wasn't. But this is for rhetorical effect. That you didn't post up a video saying that rape survivors sucked. I mean, you know, given your blog post last week. Although I understand, TJ, that if you post up a video... If you posted up a video... in which you basically said to rape victims, oh, I can't believe that you're saying rape survivor. I mean, that's like me calling someone a stub toe survivor. I'm sure that if you said those sorts of things, it wouldn't go over very well for you. So I understand why you would limit those sorts of abrasive, in-your-face sorts of things to just your blog. It's probably best suited there instead. Not as many people are going to see it. Instead, you want to post up a video talking about Thomas Aquinas sucks. It's so obvious, dude. And I'm torn because part of me, folks, I'm like, oh my goodness, he's begging for attention. How else? Why else would he? I mean, it's just so full of, you know, look, folks, I'm getting bored. I'm just going to say something sucks. I'm going to talk about Thomas Aquinas and I'm just going to say it sucks, and I'm going to bring up blueberry muffins and think that this is really an adequate explanation and substitution and whatever. So I'm not actually going to refute anything of what the Amazing Atheist says in his videos because, one, I don't think the Amazing Atheist really cares, first of all. Two, if you really do care, well then... I would be more than happy, more than interested in having a live discussion with you on Blog TV or Stickcam or somewhere if you want to. If you really are interested. That way I don't get people saying, Jack, you didn't refute his points. Because I'm thinking to myself, who in his audience really cares about his points? No one is going to be like, I doubt very many people are going to be thinking, well, the Amazing Atheist just totally is the most philosophical person out there. Oh my goodness. I don't know what it is about that guy, but when he talks about philosophy, I just am mesmerized. Now, don't get me wrong. I mean, we've got to have these sorts of ways of communicating. You know, it's like the dummy's guide to philosophy, the dummy's guide to wiping your butt. I don't know. Sometimes things can be overly complicated. You know, although wiping your butt, well, I guess if you wanted to make it overly complicated, you could. I'm not going to attempt to do that in this video, though. So anyways, you know, philosophy is like science. We can talk about it in very general, simple ways. And, you know, sort of, you know, shoot the breeze and this sort of stuff. We can take the science or the philosophy, which is really much more complicated and involved, and present it in a way that is not complicated and not involved, because really we're not interested in taking the time to think about and reflect about the complexities and the difficulties of philosophy and science. People don't like that. You folks on YouTube, that the majority that are just really into the Amazing Atheist, you watch him for the entertainment. I mean, I doubt you're going to him because you want him to teach you philosophy. I watch the Amazing Atheist in general because I find he says some things that I think are very, that he's very, can be at times very honest in his reflection of life. And I can appreciate that. But when it gets into this overly entertaining sort of stuff, I mean, I know what he's doing. And it works. And look, folks, I'm doing it right now, actually. I mean, why do you think I posted up a video response to the Amazing Atheist? So I'm not, in many ways, I can't really say that I'm better than him. Because I play the game at times the same way he does play the game. So look, I'm sure that I just want to make that clear. I'm not trying to make it sound like I'm not playing the game, that at times I'm not an attention whore, because unfortunately YouTube sort of works that way, and I don't necessarily think it's a bad thing, although in some cases I don't think it's a very beneficial thing, especially if the end result of all of that is not some way to have discussion outside of that venue. Like, for example, I'm willing to have that discussion beyond just YouTube. I'm willing to talk with people on Blog TV, have people talk with me on Skype. I'm willing to discuss these things with Amazing Atheist, TJ. I'm willing to do these sorts of things, to engage beyond this drama, this persona that I'm presenting to you right now. I'm willing to go beyond this and to reflect to you actually something that's more in alignment with the person that you would meet in real life. But at this moment, I'm wanting to engage somehow with those people that watch The Amazing Atheist, and I'm wanting to point out to them, look, you know what? The Amazing Atheist says some really stupid stuff. He's saying really stupid stuff now. I don't think it's going to be very worthwhile for me to do a 15, 20-minute video that's going to be very probably non-entertaining for you. Instead, I'm presenting to you the opportunity to engage in a discussion outside of YouTube such that we can all demonstrate that we're interested in the discussion more than we are interested in being drama whores. Now, so it's there. That's what's there right now. Okay? Be critical thinkers. Be critical thinkers. I'm waiting for, the atheists on YouTube, people are like, oh, well, the atheists are critical thinkers. That's a load of bullshit. That's what it is, okay? I have met as many atheists, the people on YouTube who are atheists are as uncritical thinking as any theist that I've ever met. I'm generalizing, obviously, because there's critical thinkers in both groups. But what I'm saying is that the atheists are no more critical in their thinking than any other person I've ever met. What I see on YouTube is, I see when it comes to the people like Thunderfoot and the Amazing Atheist and these sorts of things, you get maybe just, a small pocket of the people who will stand up and say some things about them in opposition to them. But to be honest, I think that a lot of the atheists on YouTube, the ones that really engage in the philosophical thought, who would be in many ways much more equipped to respond to the Amazing Atheist than I ever could, because they know their depth of knowledge regarding philosophy is much more extensive than my own. They could respond to the Amazing Atheist, but let's be honest, folks. We know for a fact that these people don't get, they're not very popular here on YouTube, and what I mean by that is they're not nearly as popular as individuals who are entertainers. People like, the Thunderfoot wants to make it into, I'm doing science videos and blah, 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 blah. Come on, folks. Let's get real here. Oh, Thunderfoot has spent a lot of time engaging in the drama whore business. Like I'm sort of doing right now. But we do this sort of thing at times. So I can be honest with that. I can be honest with that at this time, because that's just what I know. This is what I'm doing. This is over the top drama. Oh my goodness, I can't believe you just said that, Jack. Oh, that pisses me off, and I'm so upset. I'm going to post up a comment, and I'm going to do a response video because I want to be able to ramble and rant and vent and exactly like you are, and that's what the Amazing Atheist wants. It's going to get him the views. It's going to get him the subscribers. And I am going to piggyback off of it. But within these, of course, we are making some sort of points, obviously. I mean, it's easy to miss the points, though, when it's so over the top and all about the entertainment and sort of stuff. And when it's overly simplistic and not being entirely honest with the material set before us. But who are we kidding? I don't think the Amazing Atheist is that interested in his video and presenting some in-depth, whatever. I don't have anything more to say about that. I'd just be repeating myself. So anyways, I was talking about the atheists. So the thing is, I'd be interested to know if those atheists here on YouTube, would be willing to call out the amazing atheist. And this is so funny. The fact is, though, when it comes, this is the irony, right? So you get the atheists are like, oh, it's all about science, people. It's all about, you know, critical thinking. You hear that from so many different atheists. They sit there and some of them pretend like, oh my goodness, like we are such like the intellectual, rational, logical thinkers. And you theists out there are so irrational and delusional for believing in your stuff. But we have so got it together over here. But when you're on YouTube and you look, you're like, that's a load of crap if I've ever heard any. Because the philosophical, reasoned, critical atheist thinkers are not the most popular ones on YouTube. They're not the most popular atheist on YouTube. What's up with that? What's up with that? What's up? What's up? You know what's up with that? It's because the atheists are just like every other person. They just want to sort of get by with the, you know, the little one-liners, oversimplifications, generalizations. They don't really necessarily want to engage in an in-depth way with the things being presented to them, with the opposition that comes their way. They're not unlike most religious thinkers. I mean, they're not like people in general. I'm at 11 minutes. I wonder if I can beat Amazing Atheist 15 minutes. I could, but the thing is, I've only got 5 minutes left on my battery life. So I don't think that's going to happen right now. So, you know, the atheists want to... There is the atheist. Okay, so if you're a theist, if you're a Christian watching this, if you're a Muslim, if you're a theist, whoever, it's so clear, and I think most of us know this by now, the atheists don't demonstrate, like, this sense of, you know what, we really care about reason and rationality and critical thinking and science. They don't. And the fact is, Thunderfoot posts up a video because it's so clear that he wants support. He knows that, you know, what's funny is though, is instead of him using someone like the Amazing Atheist as an example, or Pat Condell as an example, he uses this other dude. Of course, he wants to, you know, make it sound like, you know, the fact... People like the entertainment. The atheists like the entertainment. You don't see the atheists turning out for those blog TV shows where it's about in-depth, critical, philosophical thought. No. You don't see the skeptical thinking going on there. No. What you see is the people just sort of like, oh, you know, I don't believe in God, dude. You people are stupid. You know why? Because the Bible's full of contradictions. Because you guys are irrational. Oh, you know, that was a fallacy, what you just did there right there. That was a fallacy of equivocation right there. Yeah, I can name all the fallacies. I can list the fallacies. You want me to list fallacies? I know how to list fallacies. I can tell, oh, that was a fallacy right there. You did fallacy of appeal to authority. Oh, fallacy of appeal to emotion. Fallacy of appeal to something, you know. But when it comes to, like, demonstrating more, nothing. This is why atheism is so unappealing to me. Because not only does it not accord with the intuition within that cries out and testifies to there being something more than self, but the people who adhere to this proposition that there is no God, and all the atheists are going to be like, oh, Jack, this is not a proposition. I'm not claiming anything. This is the thing is, the atheists, so many of them don't even get this. They're not delving into the reason, the rationality, the logic. They're on the peripheral, playing stupid with it all. Not unlike most religious people. I'm not saying they're you know, worse than the religious. I mean, the religious people do the same thing. But, you know, the atheists prop themselves up as being better than the religious people. That's what I'm getting at. And they prop themselves up on being better, not based upon something transcendent, which, you know, religious people tend to do. I'm better than you because I believe in God, and you don't believe in God. Therefore, you are immoral, and you are horrible, and I can't trust you. That's religious people do that, right? We know a lot of religious people do that. But the atheists are like, you know what? I'm going to prop myself based up on logic, and I have reason. And I'm like, that just sounds stupid. That is just ridiculous. Are you kidding me? Okay, I've got 1 minute left. This isn't going to work. I've ranted, I've raved, enough as I can. I've got a blog. I know this is shameless promo. If you don't like these sorts of drama videos, well, I've got other videos up that aren't like this that are actually more realistic. But from time to time, I enjoy this sort of thing. Yeah. I guess enjoyment perhaps isn't the best word. But I know some of you enjoy it. I know you enjoy it. It pisses you off. You enjoy being upset about these things. You enjoy being mad at me, thinking I'm a crazy delusional Christian. Maybe I am. Let me think about that.